Hey guys, in this video I will show you how to execute a Python file from Excel using the MyToolBelt add-in. You just need to click this button and select the Python file you want to execute. This feature is available in the free version of the add-in. And in this video I will show you some practical use cases. But if you have never heard about this add-in before, I recommend checking out my website where I explain the core functionalities. But keep in mind that this add-in only works on Windows. Okay, and with that out of the way, let us get started. Here in Excel, I have already installed the latest MyToolBelt version. If you have not installed it yet, I will leave the link with the detailed installation instructions in the info card above. Also, if you have already installed the add-in, but you do not see this button, you probably use an older version. Updating your version takes only 1 minute. In the following video, I will guide you through the update process. You can find that video also in the info card above. Okay, and with that said, let me demonstrate the new feature. I have a table with different tasks, the start and finish date, and the current completion rate. I intend now to leverage the power of Python to create an interactive Gantt chart from this data. Therefore, I have made the following Python file. In the script, I'm converting the sheet into a pandas data frame and using the plotly express library to create the Gantt chart. I also have a dedicated video explaining the code line by line. I will leave the link to that video in the info card above. The neat thing is that the script is quite flexible, so without adjusting the code, I could add more tasks, which will be reflected in the chart. However, the downside is that I always need to execute the Python code from my terminal or text editor. Wouldn't it be cool to call the Python file directly from Excel? In the past, I usually wrote a small VBA macro to do exactly that, but I thought it might be a good idea to add this functionality also to the MyToolBelt add-in. So instead of writing a VBA macro to execute a Python file, you can now just click the following button. If you click it for the first time, you will get the following message. As written in the message box, you need to locate at least one Python interpreter to execute your Python code from Excel. So you need to enter the path to your python.exe file. If you click on yes, you will see the following Python settings menu. You can also navigate to this settings window by clicking the following button. You want to add the Python path to your Python executable file in this settings window. I also have included some example paths. Now, there are various ways to find out your Python path. A quick Google search will show you different methods. One option is to open your command prompt or terminal and type where_python. In my case, my Python interpreter is located under the following path. So let me add this path to my settings. For me, it is under my username in a folder called miniconda. In this folder, I can find my Python executable file. Once selected, you can save and close this window. With that in place, I will now click the One Python button again. This time I can select my Python file. The script I want to execute is in the Python scripts folder. Let me choose this file and click on select. Okay, it seems nothing happened, but if I check my folder, I can see that the add-in executed the Python script successfully and that I have my Gantt chart in an HTML file. Now, if you do not get an error, this means your Python code ran successfully. However, you can also show the console while executing the script. Therefore, let me open up the settings menu again. Here, you can check the following options. This can be helpful if you are using any print commands in your code, as those will be printed to the console. But keep in mind that the console will close automatically once your Python code got executed. If you want, you can also keep the console open after running your script. If I now rerun the Python file, the add-in will open up your terminal. In my case, I have also inserted some print commands in the Python code. Once the execution is finished, I can now close this window. Okay, but there might be also a case where you want to execute your Python code from a virtual environment. To do that, you can add multiple Python paths to your settings. Yet, this feature is only available in the paid version. But to demonstrate to you that feature, let me add another Python path. This time I will choose a Python 3.10 version. I already know that I have not pandas installed in that Python environment, and I need pandas to create the Gantt chart. So let us see what happens if I call the script with that Python interpreter. As you might have expected, you will see an error in the console. In my case, I am currently missing the pandas module. If you have decided to hide the console while executing the script and facing an error in your Python code, you will get a message box with the error message. So when you see a message box like this, you know that Python got executed, but there's a bug in your code. Okay, and now there's only one button left in the settings menu. As the button name suggests, you can also delete a Python path from your settings. So if you click this button, the add-in will delete the currently selected option from the combo box. Now that you have seen all the settings, let me show you some more use cases. In this example, I want to transform the following dataset into an interactive bar chart. As a first step, I will convert the data into a pandas data frame. Please note that this feature is only available in the paid version. If you click this button, the add-in will ask you to select your cell range. So let me choose the respective range and hit OK. After that, you will find a new Python file in your workbooks directory. In the script, you will see that the add-in has constructed a pandas data frame for you. Let me now go ahead and use this data frame to create an interactive chart. To do so, I'm going to use the PyEcharts library. After importing PyEcharts, I will group the data by the month number, and I'm only interested in the sum of the sales and profit. With that in place, I will initialize a bar chart object, add my x and y axis, set the title, and render the chart to a standalone HTML file. By the way, I also have a dedicated video to explain the PyEcharts module in more depth. You will find the link to that video in the info card above. Okay, and with that script in place, I can now run the Python code from Excel. As a result, I've got back this interactive bar chart where I can zoom in and out to different months and toggle on or off the sales and profit. I hope you can see how this add-in can help you to speed up your workflows and leverage the power of Python right from Excel. Okay, and for the last example, I'm going to use the Excel Wings and YFinance package to pull stock data. So let us say I want to get the market data for Apple for the last 5 days. After my input, I will run my Python file, and as a result, my spreadsheet got updated. So every time I change my input and rerun the script, my worksheet will be updated. I will, of course, also upload this workbook and the Python file to GitHub in case you're interested in the code. The code heavily depends on the Excel Wings library, and I would like to mention that there's also an Excel Wings add-in available, which lets you execute Python files from Excel. That add-in even works on macOS, and on my channel I also have a dedicated video on how to use it. Yet I wanted to have a little more flexibility when it comes to choosing the Python file and running it from different interpreters. Besides, I like the idea of having all my tools only in one add-in. Because you might have noticed that there are many more buttons over here. Most of those features are available in the free version, like highlighting a cell range with a red shape, or inserting tick marks. You could also change a tick mark's position in the settings menu. Instead of placing the tick marks inside the cells, you could also place them next to the cell. Or you could even create a table of contents with a gallery view with a click of a button. Now you've got a new worksheet with little previews of the different tabs. If you click on the image, you will be redirected to the respective sheet. You could also insert a button to get back to the table of contents sheet. And also, here you have a lot more customization options in the settings menu. So have a look at the add-in. I'm sure you will love it, and if you have any feature request, let me know in the comments, or you could directly send me a message right from the add-in. Therefore, navigate to add-in, and under suggestions, you can let me know how I could improve this add-in to meet your needs better. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video!